Perfect. Hey, sweet babies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. So you definitely seen this outfit before because I did record a video earlier today, and tonight I'm recording another video. It's late. What time is it? It's 8:49. It's time for me to wind down. So I'm gonna go ahead and run through these empties real quick. So usually I do my empties quarterly, so this would be April through June. I don't have much, but I'm gonna still run through these kind of quick so I can let y'all know how I feel about them. Were they worth repurchasing or not? Because y'all know I'm gonna tell y'all right. So let's jump right into it. The African Pride pre-poop, always in my stash. Y'all already know I love it. Of course it's bae. Of course it'll be repurchased. This is by The Main Choice. This is their green tea and carrot like original. The sign done came off or whatever, but this was actually good. This was the first time I used it and I really did like it. Like, I will repurchase this. This was a good deep conditioner. It gave me strengthening and so it was like a good moisture protein balance. So this was a yes. This is the Arcani Coil Care and Throne Edges Edge Control. Now this is a big 8-ounce edge control, and I had got it on sale like a year ago, and this was like my go-to edge control, and I've been using it ever since, and it's finally gone. This one was $25, but I got it like on sale. It might have been half off or something like that. I like this edge control. It actually lasts all day. They say that it's like supposed to last you like a whole week and all that. It ain't doing all that, but it's gonna get you through your whole day. So I would absolutely repurchase this. The Ginger Mint Co-Wash from Oyen. I like this. This is a good co-wash. It smells good. It feels good on your scalp. I like the creamy like type of texture. This was really good. It's not enough in here for me. This is too small. I need a bigger one for sure. But this is a good co-wash and I will repurchase. This Almond Milk Deep Conditioner from Carol's Daughter. Like, Carol's Daughter is killing it with deep conditioners. This was good. Their Cocoa Creme Deep Conditioner was good. I will absolutely repurchase this. Nice moisturizing. Smooth, like a little slip when you put it on your hair. So this was good and I liked it. This is the Banana Leave-In by Nature's Little Secret. I really do like this leave-in. I think it's a nice consistency, not too thick, not too thin. It smells like bananas and I just really like this, so I will repurchase it. I actually have another one. This is Nature's Little Secret Flaxseed Curling Custard. Now this isn't all the way gone, but I had it for a really long time and it's like kind of watery now, so I'm just gonna go ahead and get rid of it. But when I used it, I really did like it. Didn't use it for a wash and go, but I did use it for a twist out. My definition was on point and my definition lasted and it still gave me like a nice medium hold. So I would absolutely repurchase this. The Jello Shot by EcoSlay. This is a strong gel. Like, if you are having a hard time taming your curls for a wash and go, this is really good. I suggest this for really anybody that has like tight coiled hair and their wash and goes just don't define. Like, I think this is a gel that might help you because it's super heavy and it's crunchy, girl. It's real crunchy, so you need a super moisturizing leave-in under it. Would I repurchase it? Probably not. I did like it. It definitely gave me good definition, but it was a little drying, and the fact that you have to leave this in the refrigerator, I just kept forgetting about it, and yeah, so I just wouldn't repurchase this. This is the Honey and Hibiscus This is the Honey and Hibiscus More Moisture Please Deep Conditioner by Curl Origin. This was just okay. I thought it was gonna give me more moisture, but it didn't. It was okay. I didn't get the moisture that I wanted from it. I have some other Curl Origin deep conditioners that I want to try, but this one just didn't do what I thought it was gonna do. The Ayurvedic Pre-Poo by The Main Crush. This was a good pre-poo. I did not use it correctly because you're supposed to put it on your hair and leave it on for 45 minutes. I didn't do that. I just literally just pre-pooed with it. But I did like it. It left my hair soft and manageable. And I would repurchase it. And the next time I do repurchase it, I would leave it on for 45 minutes because I want to see what the difference is. This is the Cocoa Creme Clay Wash by Chocolate Kinks and Curls. this was the first one that I used, and I see why you guys like the clay washer from Chocolate Kings and Curls. They're simple, they're easy, they do what they're supposed to do. My hair was nice and soft, it felt really good, my hair was clean. This one is the Detox Detangler Conditioner. I didn't really get the detangling aspects, maybe because I use a lot of product, I'm really heavy-handed, but even with me being heavy-handed, I got like 3 uses out of this, so I was really surprised at that, because that's not normal for me for an 8-ounce bottle. So this was good, and I see why you guys love them. It is a good co-wash, and I actually have some more over there, so repurchase, sure. Now this deep conditioner from Kiki Tresses, this was more on the strengthening side. It didn't have much moisture when I used it the first time, so the second time I used it and I mixed it in with a moisturizing deep conditioner, and I really liked it better because I got that moisture protein balance. But if you're looking for something a little stronger with more protein, this is definitely restorative. It definitely gives you strengthening properties, so if that's what you're looking for, this would be good for that. But for me, I just need more moisture and protein in my deep conditioner. This is the Curlific Texture Treatment from Afogee. I like this. This is like really, it's supposed to be like a 1-minute mask, but of course when you're distributing it through your hair, of course it's gonna take longer than 1 minute, but you're not supposed to leave it on long. If you do, it will just continue to strengthen and strengthen and strengthen your hair. It's pretty strengthening. It's not hella moisturizing though, so this is something that I would also either use on my own and just don't leave it on my hair long, or mix it in with a moisturizing deep conditioner. But it does give you a nice protein strengthening moment for sure. This is the TGIN Honey Miracle Mask. I use this off camera, of course, because we are pretty much all familiar with this. This is a good deep conditioner for anybody, any hair type. It does have silicone, so if you don't like silicone, of course stay away from it, but if you don't mind, this is good. It's moisturizing. I've been using this since I started my journey 4 years ago, so this is a good deep conditioner. These are 2 co-washes by Honey's Handmade. This is the Coconut Cream Infused Carrot and Vanilla Co-Wash, and this is the Black Soap and Honey Avocado Co-Wash. This one, coconut cream one, of course, it smells better. It felt a little better applying it to my hair. It left my hair nice and soft, like I did like it, but this one made my hair feel better. So the Black Soap one made my hair feel better and look a little bit more moisturized too. So I like this one better, but this one, the experience of this one was better. This is the Co-Silkening Conditioner by Danify. I did like this. It gave me nice like moisture. I only left it on for 20 minutes because I had to go get my silk press, but I wish I could have left it on longer, and I think it doubles as a co-wash too. This was a nice deep conditioner, and I will repurchase. This is the Curl Next Door Curl Enhancing Conditioner by Cake. This was just okay. It was not a great conditioner. It's not nothing I will repurchase. This is the Sweet Honey Enriching Hair Nourisher by Henna Soup. I really did like this. I used it on my hair just like by itself, and it worked really good. It feels really like a scrub when you start to put it on, but it does melt into your hair, especially if your hair is like wet. So I used it before I put on a deep conditioner, and it really is good and moisturizing. Gave my hair like a nice, you know, soft feeling and some shine. And then the second time I used it to use it up, I mixed this in with a deep conditioner. Still great effect, so I will repurchase. This is the Edge Fixer Max Hold by Kiss. This was okay. It wasn't like a great edge control, but it was okay. I mean, I've used worse, but I've used better. Would I repurchase? Probably not. So I told y'all I didn't have much. I went through them pretty quick. So I hope you guys enjoyed this empties video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.